this very day. I will give the carcass of the Philistine army to the birds and the wild animals and the whole world. We know that there is a God in Israel. Amen. All those gathered here, we know that it is not by sword or spear that the Lord saves. For the battle is the Lord, and he will give all of you your enemies into your hands. Mm. When you leaders are fighting the cause of truth and justice, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Always remember what David said before his own Goliath. It is not by sword or by spear that the Lord saves, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will overcome the Goliath challenging you. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Now here, David adopted positive attitude, which provoked his positive anger to cry to the God of Israel to use him to fight God's cause for the glory of God. He was not thinking of himself. He was not thinking of the gift the king would give him. He was not risking his life for his own glory, unlike all the others who also wished they could fight the Goliath and become the son-in-law of the king. David saw the Goliath and he saw him as the enemy of God and the enemy of the children of Israel. So he did not pray to God this time to enter the heart of the Goliath so he could change his mind. Even though we believe that, pray for your enemy. But when the Goliath is standing in front of you, say, pray for my enemy, he will cut off your hair before your prayer is answered. So David saw the Goliath as the enemy of God anyway. And he didn't stand there to say, God, change his mind, change his mind. But that through him, David, he could destroy the Goliath in their lives. We all, at one stage in our lives, also have been challenged and comforted by Goliath in our lives. Mm-hmm. My prayer this morning is that the Almighty God that we are serving in spirit and in truth will demolish any Goliath in your life. Yeah. And any demonic forces threatening the life of your children, your job, your marital home, your happiness and your peace. Yeah. As the God of Abraham, God of Isaac and God of Jacob stood with and demolished the walls of Jericho for his own people, so will our God, who we serve with one heart, demolish all the walls of Jericho in our lives, in our church, in our family. It shall be well with us in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Now, so, deal with your anger in an expeditious manner. Always ask yourself these pertinent questions, as oftentimes some people forget why they continue to be angry and remain miserable. What am I angry about? Sometimes I'm just angry, I don't know what I'm angry about. And how my fridge filled to capacity, I can't even get any space inside the fridge anymore, and yet I'm angry. What am I angry about? I'm not starving. Ask yourself if there is any justification for any anger. Put yourself in others' position. What would you have done? Why am I angry? Put yourself in other position. If you are that leader that everybody's bombarding, what will you do? Is it easy to be a leader? Is it easy to lead hot head and cold head and warm head and look warm head? Put yourself in that position. What will you do? Can you please the world? Can you please everybody at the same time? If Jesus Christ, our own Lord and Savior, could not please everybody at the same time, how much more we mortals? Why am I angry? Is it because I don't have my ways? Because I don't expect to be corrected? Have I not been selfish or inconsiderate? Ask yourself if you are truly in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
And see what is an honest and gracious way to deal with this. There is no better way to deal with your anger other than following the example of our Lord as believer Christian. You can be angry, but never allow the sun to go down on your anger.
Amen.
You are the one that is being poisoned, as anger is like an acid.
Hallelujah.
And the longer it stays in you, the more damage it does to your aura.
Amen.
Then, seek to resolve the conflict that angers you quickly, and do so in love. Never allow your anger to remain inside you, as it will poison you. As we also read in Ephesians 4:25-27, therefore, laying aside falsehood, speak truth, each one of you, with his neighbor. For we are members of one body. Be angry, and yet do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, and do not give the devil an opportunity. Many of us do not realize the havoc that anger does to our body, our spirit. Let me share some of the popular quotes of how wise people see anger. How wise people see anger. Anybody can be angry. That is easy. But to be angry with the right person and to the right degree and at the right time and for the right purpose and in the right way. Can you believe this? To be angry with the right person, to the right degree, and at the right time, and for the right purpose, and in the right way. That is not within everybody's power, and it is not easy. That was Aristotle. David was angry for the Lord, just like the Lord was angry with the money lenders in the temple of God. With anger, he drove them out. As we also read in Matthew 21:12-14, and Jesus entered the temple and drove out all those who were buying and selling in the temple and overturned the tables of the money changers and the seats of those who were selling doves. And he said to them, it is written, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you are making it a robber's den.
Yes.
One needs to be in that state of anger to have the courage, to have the passion, and to be bold enough to challenge and throw away all the things that are not of God.
Amen.
While no one will be able to challenge you, because Satan in them recognizes the Spirit of God working in you at that particular time. At that particular time, you are fighting for God. Satan has no chance on you, because he knows that you are wearing the armor of God. And the aura of God is with you. And so Jesus Christ was very, very angry. And what did he do? He turned his own anger into positivity. He threw away the money changers. He said, you have turned, this should be called the house of my father, but you have turned it into robber's den. He drove them out. He was the only man. And there were thousands, they could have lynched him. They could have beaten me up. I mean, it's like me going to Walmart or anywhere. They will beat me out until I'm tired. But no one could touch him. Speak when you are angry. And you make the best speech you ever regret. Speak when you are angry. And you make the best speech you ever regret. If you speak in anger, sometimes you may regret it. In other words, if you can help it, when you are angry, refrain from lashing out or yelling back at the one correcting you or asking you simple questions, as your sense of dignity will be disturbed and you will say ugly things which in your rational thinking state you would never say. Some people in that rage will go to the extent of letting loose all the confidential information entrusted to them by people who think they can be trusted, and you end up becoming an untrustworthy person of unstable mind among their friends and loved ones. I have seen some housewives. The day they quarrel with their husband, that's the day you come to know that the husband is indebted to everybody in the country. She will say, yeah, he did this, he did that.